Here on Earth, we use GPS to tell you where you are and give you directions where you want to go. Once we leave the Earth's orbit, we don't have GPS signals. And for that reason, we need some kind of onboard sensor to tell us our position and velocity, like the GPS does for us here on Earth. NASA has been relying on radar sensors for the landing vehicles that go to the moon and other planetary destinations. But there are some limitations with the radar, and using the LiDAR, it can overcome those limitations. Radar beams are divergent. They diverge as they hit the ground. The laser beams are pencil beams, so it makes the measurement more precise. The navigation Doppler LiDAR we built here, we see as becoming a standard sensors for the future NASA missions. The laser sensors can be smaller and more efficient, which is a big deal when you're going to the moon or Mars. Every ounce counts. It can actually help reduce the cost of the missions. Because of the high quality of the data, a lot of the design margins that go in the landing vehicle can be relaxed. For example, the lander's leg band can be reduced because you know your velocity much better, or you don't have to carry as much fuel reserves. These are all significant cost savings using the navigation Doppler LiDAR. This is one of those technologies that is finding a lot of spin-off commercial applications, especially in situations where the GPS signal is not reliable, particularly for autonomous aircrafts and driverless cars. Derivative of this technology can play a very critical role in enabling safe and efficient driverless cars.